Hello everyone, my name's Liana and I'm interrupting the regularly scheduled programming to bring you your OCI news for the week. Let's get started. First up, great news for users of GraalVM. Coming up in the next release of the JDK, native image will be included out of the box. For those of you who might be unaware of what GraalVM is, we're talking about a high-performance JDK distribution designed to accelerate the execution of applications written in Java, along with support for JavaScript, Ruby, Python, and a number of other popular languages. With GraalVM, you can compile Java bytecode into a platform-specific, self-contained, native executable to achieve a faster startup and smaller footprint for your application. This native image functionality will now be available by default, so you will no longer need to install it with the GraalVM updater tool. Next, let's switch gears a bit and talk about Oracle Container Engine for Kubernetes. KubeArmor, a cloud-native security solution, now supports OKE to secure pods and containers using the BPF LSM for inline attack mitigation and prevention. In the case of Kubernetes, the pods are the execution units and are usually exposed to external entities. Thus, it's imperative to have a layer of defense within the pods so that the attacker is limited in their ability to use system primitives to exploit the vulnerability. KubeArmor is a Kubernetes-native solution that uses Linux kernel primitives on unbreakable enterprise kernel to harden the pods, further fortifying the Kubernetes engine. Moving on, a bit of news for those of you who use application performance monitoring. This is a tool that provides observability for visibility and diagnosis across your entire IT environment by using distributed transaction tracing. The great news is that the OpenTelemetry native protocol is now supported. You can configure OpenTelemetry data sources to upload trace and metric data using the native OpenTelemetry protocol directly to APM. For more information on how to set it up, be sure to check the links in the description. Switching gears now to the compute service, there is great news for users of Linux virtual machines. Oracle Autonomous Linux 8 is now available as a platform image. If you're not aware of what Oracle Autonomous Linux is, it is based on Oracle Linux and is used to create autonomous Linux instances. Some of the benefits that you'd get from these are automatic daily upgrades, including zero downtime ksplice updates for kernel OpenSSL and glibc libraries, monitoring for critical events such as kernel loops or kernel crashes, including collecting and submitting the messages and logs needed to debug and provide a root cause analysis of the event. Next up, Visual Builder Studio users may be happy to hear that the service is finally available in Gen 2 Cloud. For those unaware, Visual Builder Studio is a cloud app dev platform targeted towards front-end developers with lots of cool features to collaborate, test, and deploy your apps. You can use it to build both web and mobile applications written in Oracle Jet, which is a JavaScript extension toolkit. And it's got an intuitive drag-and-drop interface that also allows advanced code customization where necessary. With this latest update, you can now create instances of Visual Builder and Visual Builder Studio both directly from your OCI console. The VB Studio instance needs to be created at root level. And for more information, again, make sure to look in the links in the description. And to close off, let's talk a bit about some recent service change announcements. Today, we're covering the Big Data service because on January 31st, 2023, the agreement between Oracle and Cloudera has expired. As a result, starting on January 31st, Oracle Big Data Service will no longer support using the Cloudera distribution, including Apache Hadoop, to launch new clusters or add nodes or cores to existing clusters beyond a set limit. This change does not impact ongoing support of existing Big Data Service CDH clusters. And it's worth noting that this change is applicable only to Big Data Service CDH and will not impact on-premises Oracle Big Data Appliance or Big Data Services with Oracle distribution of Hadoop. That was all I have for you on this episode of What's New in OCI. Hope you've enjoyed the information. Happy coding, and I'll see you all next time.